In this video, we will compare box plots to determine if two distributions are similar or not. So let's start by looking at some body measurements. Here I have data for 507 adults. The variable in this dot plot is hip girth, the distance around the widest part of the hips measured in centimeters. Now I'm going to add a categorical variable, gender, and I'm going to color code the data as male or female. Gold dots represent women and blue dots represent men. What I notice is that both males and females appear to be distributed similarly throughout the sample. In other words, I see gold dots throughout and blue dots throughout. This suggests to me that the distributions of hip measurements for men and women really are very similar. So let's separate this distribution into two distributions, one for men and one for women. Now, when I look at the separate distributions, they really do look very similar. Let's add some box plots to make this comparison more precise. I'm going to decrease the size of the dots so that I can see the box plots better. I haven't removed data or anything, I'm just making the dots smaller. Now I'm going to move reference lines or to mark the median, and we know the median is the middle of the box, so, or the line that's within the box to be more precise. And so the median hip measurement for females is 95 centimeters, and for males, it looks like it is 97 centimeters. So males have a slightly larger average hip measurement than women. Now, how do I reconcile this observation with my earlier observation that the distributions really do look very similar? The answer is that I need to consider the variability in the data, not just a measure of center like the median. I need to consider this 2 centimeter difference in the medians in light of the variability that I see about the medians. So to spread into account, let's compare an interval of typical values instead of just comparing medians. Now, we know that typical values can be described by the interval between the first quartile mark and the third quartile mark. That's the middle half of the distribution, and that's the box part of the box plot. So I'm going to shade that right now just so that we can see it easier. And so the gray region is the middle half of the data, and it's what we will consider typical measurements. Now, the first thing I notice is that if I'm looking at the first quartile mark for men, which is 93, and the third quartile mark, which is 102, that interval describes typical men, and actually there's quite a few women that lie within that interval. Similarly, if I find typical measurements for women going from a first quartile mark of 91 to a second quartile, the third quartile mark of 100, I can see that there are a lot of men that lie within that typical interval for women. So because these boxes overlap so substantially, the intervals of typical measurements overlap substantially, this tells me that the 2 centimeter difference in the medians is really not substantial in light of the spread that we see. We can conclude that hip measurements for typical men and typical women in this sample are similar. Men do not tend to have larger hips. Now let's look at a dot plot of a different variable. This time I'm looking at the ankle diameter for these same 507 adults. And let's again color code by gender so we can compare the males and females. Now what I notice this time is that women do tend to be smaller. I see a lot more of the gold dots, which represent women, with the smaller measurements, and men are mainly on the upper end. Let's go ahead and separate this distribution into two distributions based on gender. Okay, now when I separate these, it does look like the distribution for men really is, that men have higher measurements. The distribution is slid along to the right much more than when I'm comparing to the women. So let's make this more precise again using a box plot. And I'm gonna do the same thing I did before, make the dots a little smaller so I can see the box plots better. Okay, what do we notice this time? Let's compare the medians again, and I'll use reference lines to do that. And we see again that The male's median is larger than females. Let's see, the male median is about 14.8 centimeters, and for females, it's about 13 centimeters. So the medians differ by 1.8 centimeters, which is, less than half the length of a paperclip. All right, but we have to consider this difference relative to the spread in the medians, like we did before. So let's shade the middle half of the data again in each distribution so that we can really compare typical men. Let me scoot that over so I could get this. Okay, typical men to typical women. Okay, so before I mess around with changing the reference lines, let's just visually compare. When I look at this interval of typical measurements for men, there are very few women that have that large of an ankle diameter. And when I look at the typical measurements for women, there are very few men with that small of an ankle diameter. So again, let's make this more precise by actually finding the first and third quartile marks so we can make a comparison of typical intervals. So men, typically the middle half of the distribution ranges between 14.2 centimeters and 15.3 centimeters. And there aren't very many women with that size of an ankle. And if we look at typical women, they range between about 12.4 centimeters and 13.75 centimeters. And again, not very men, very many men have ankles that small. So in other words, because the boxes do not overlap, typical men tend to be larger than typical women in this sample for ankle diameter. For this reason, I would say that we really do have substantial differences between men and women in this sample. Now, in summary, to judge whether two distributions are similar or substantially different, we need to do more than compare medians. We have to consider the spread in the data about the medians. With hips, a 2 centimeter difference in the medians was not substantial. We concluded men and women were pretty similar with hip measurements. But with ankles, the smaller 1.8 centimeter difference was substantial because typical men and women, had different measurements. Men tended to be larger.